Will we do those one after the other in the pregame? Okay. Okay. All right, good. Good, gotcha. What's good? Looks good to me. Looks good. That's it, Taylorsville. There you go. Yes.
It doesn't look centered. Look like it could be
it's
over,
centered
over
on the red. It's centered on the red.
Yeah.
You're wanting it centered under the MHSAA
red.
Graphic. I can hear you real loud, but I can't hear Stephanie very well. I cannot hear Stephanie very well. I can't even hear myself very well. Can hear you great. Gotcha.
Do I need to adjust my headset too?
But that's, okay, well that's the earphones. Mine's all the way up. Yep. Go ahead, roll yours.
Okay.
Roll yours on. Okay, is that all the way up?
It's all the way up.
All right. Stephanie, what, question about Walnut? Are they fairly new school? Or?
See, I'm having a hard time hearing
you. You're having a hard time hearing me?
Yes.
Yeah, see. Okay, let's see.
All right, what are you asking?
Walnut, are they fairly new school?
I hadn't heard much about them.
No, because I don't think
they've never been to a state championship or been up in the Coliseum?
I don't think so. Yeah, well, you're loud. Yeah, that's better. That's better. Yep. In fact, I need to turn it down a little bit. I can turn it down on my end. Yeah. Now we're
okay.
Sounding good.
Okay, I can hear you.
Sound better?
Yeah.
Yep. You can turn yours down.
Turn it down a little bit.
I want to turn it down a light.
Okay.
Turn it down a little bit. All right.
Is that better?
Yep. Yep.
Okay.
I'm not going to scare you. I'll be back in 60 seconds. Hold on. I'm going to ask one quick question.
Yes, I'm here. I think Josh stepped off in about 60 seconds. He just said he'll be back in 60 seconds. He's standing here now talking to Sandy.
All right, first time for Walnut since 1997. I'm not going to told you I wasn't going to scare you. So we're actually not going to go at zero. We're going to go right after the national anthem. Okay.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to the Big House. Mississippi High School State Basketball Playoff Game presented by the Mississippi High School Activity Association and Ceasefire Wireless. This afternoon's Class 2A Playoff Game features the visiting team, the Walnut Lady Wildcats, and the home team, the Taylorsville Lady Tigers. This time we ask that you please rise and remove all headgear for presentation colors and a national anthem. With our Mississippi flag this afternoon, a senior from Walnut, Erica.
You're going to count us in, Mark.
The United States flag this afternoon, a freshman from Taylorsville, Cambry Griffin. Ladies and gentlemen, this time, out of the United States of America, here is our national anthem.
Welcome to Jackson, Mississippi, MHSAA State Championships as we are getting you ready for the 2A semifinals. Walnut High School Lady Wildcats taking on the Taylorsville High School Lady Tartars. Josh West alongside Stephanie Murphy. So glad that you are with us as we are, or you are joining us, I should say, on the Mississippi High School Activity Association Network, the MHSAA Network coverage with all 36 semifinal games, rather I should say just all 36 games of this tournament. As we get ready for these starting lineups, it's time for us to take a look at these starting lineups. First, we'll take a look at the starting lineups for Walnut. For Walnut, it is going to be a 5'5 senior, Wynesha Adams. Joining her will be a 5'6 senior, Taylor Doyle. Also in the lineup, a 5'9 senior, Riley Quinn, also the 5'7 senior Presley Pulse, and then also the 5'9 senior Becky Robinson. Adams and Doyle and Pulse make up the backcourt. Quinn and Robinson, the forwards for head coach Larry Tribble. Walnut comes in 25-8 on this season, coming off a 80-36 setback to Newsite as they are the North number two seed, the North runner-up. They are taking on Taylorsville, the South number one seed. Taylorsville riding a 12-game winning streak, 24-3 on the season, coming off a very convincing South State Championship win over Bassville, 57-40. As we take a look at the Taylorsville starting lineups for head coach Angela Moore, it will be Tamara McCurdy, the 5'6 junior at a guard. Joining her in the backcourt will be Coco Bender, the senior at 5'5. Also in the lineup at a guard, the senior at 5'8, Letitia McCullum. And then the forwards down low, it'll be Sharnae Keys, a 6-foot senior. And then also it'll be Tamisha Horn, a 5'11 junior. So McCurdy, Bender, McCullum the guards, Keys, and Horn the forwards. And with that, I turn to my partner. Welcome in Stephanie Murphy. Stephanie, boy, this is the state championship atmosphere, the energy, the excitement. Earlier in the first game, it was Bassville falling 55-44 to Newsite. The winner of this game gets that winner, Newsite, who defeated Bassville by 10. But there are a lot of nerves in that game. You being a head coach, what do you tell your team coming out right now to try to settle them down? Because, boy, you talk about the butterflies being at an all-time high.
Right. The main thing, you know, you want to kind of keep it as consistent as possible. Whatever your normal routine is, you're doing a regular season game, you want to do it in the Coliseum so it takes a little bit of the pressure away. But I've been in this position as a player when I was a senior at West Tallahatchie, and also as a coach several times being in the Coliseum. But the main thing is just trying to keep everything as consistent as possible so they're not thinking that they're being actually in the Coliseum.
when you get in this situation, if you do see early nerves, when you were a coach, did you, or you are a coach, as you let your team play, do you let them go, or do you call an early timeout to try to reel them back in? Because, again, we're going to see a lot of crazy things here probably for the through the first few minutes.
I've done it both ways. I think earlier as a coach, I would probably call a timeout to settle them down. But I think as I've gotten older, you try to let them play and let it, the nerves kind of go out on their own.
Well, as you look out onto the floor, you see that Walnut in their road black uniforms. Taylorsville going to be in the home white. And we're going to see Walnut move from right to left on your screen. Taylorsville from left to right. Lady Tarners against the Lady Wildcats. Two of the best teams in 2A basketball in the state of Mississippi. As we're about to jump it up here at the center of the floor, it'll be Horn jumping it up for the Tarners. Here's the tip coming up. And there it is, and we're underway. And it's controlled by Walnut in the front court. With the basketball between the rings is Paulson. They'll set it up, and we see Taylorsville coming out in man pressure early. So we'll see if Walnut, how patient they'll be here. No shot clock in Mississippi High School basketball as we see a drive and a penetration, a kick out to Doyle. Very interested to see the game plan. Will they settle for early jumpers? Will the Wildcats, or will they try to work it inside and get an easy layup opportunity early? Here's a drive by Becky Robinson, losing it. Bodies to the floor, nearly a held ball. But Walnut will retain possession. Just 35 seconds into a scoreless first quarter.
It was great defense early on by Taylorsville. Really communicating and talking on the screens. A lot of good defense early on.
Again, as we see Walnut take their time, would you be an advocate for shot clock in high school basketball? What do you think? Maybe even 35 or 40 seconds?
I think it would be fun. But at the end of the game, you kind of like being able to run the clock out. So
no, that's true. That's the flip side of this coin, as Walnut takes their time here with the basketball. Quinn working with it right wing. Miss an open player inside. And again, as you touched on, Coach, Taylorsville, they'll do this all afternoon. Just settling in. Here's Quinn now. Rotates back up between the circles.
It looks to be the game plan of Walnut to try to be patient the way Taylorsville breaks down. It looks like this was intentional, just to be patient.
Adams driving the shot up, a back iron miss, and a nice rebound, but losing her footing that time and going down and turning it over was Tamara McCurdy, the junior. So to go right back to Walnut, so Walnut gets to do it all over again. They got a good look, they'll get a chance for another one. From the baseline, Quinn to inbound. Gets it in along the left side. Here's Doyle up top to Adams. Adams now on a bounce over to Pulse. As you touched on, Coach, we're going to see Walnut be very patient, but you got to like Taylorsville. Taylorsville, they can't get greedy. They've got to also be patient. On the left side, here's Doyle. Right of the circle. Dribble drive into the lane to the bucket. Good layup attempt, too strong. Saved in underneath the bucket. And Taylorsville's got possession, a held ball. And it's going to be McCurdy that was tied up, and the arrow now with the Tarters. So, 2 minutes into this game, we're going to get to see Taylorsville finally go on offense.
You think that it has to be the strategy of Walnut is to try to slow the game down. It took 2 minutes off the clock in the first quarter, so I think that's probably the game plan to try to keep it maybe low scoring.
5:50 to go, first quarter, no score. Tarters on offense for the first time in this one. 2A semifinal, pass inside, turnaround shot off the glass and in. Sharnay Keys, the senior, settling her team down early. 2-0 Tarters. Here comes Walnut in a hurry, pushing with Pulse, and she puts it in on the run. Tough shot over a defender.
Yeah, it's a tough shot.
Taylorsville not wasting any time now. Taylorsville wants to up this tempo. Here is Coco Bender into the left corner. Horn now back inside. Swing it out, McCurdy. Here's a 15-footer. Back iron miss. Rebound underneath. Offensive board and a stick back. There's Tamisha Horn, the junior. She had 13 in that South State win of her basketball. She's her second leading scorer. And boy, offensive boards early for Taylorsville as Walnut pushes the other way. In transition, Walnut to the hole. There's Taylor Doyle.
Yeah. Walnut's getting out a little bit more in transition. So maybe they're trying to beat the bigger down the floor.
Tie game again. 4:50 to go, first quarter. Along the baseline, it's Horn. Pass inside, turning left shoulder, going up and drawing the foul. Is going to be Sharnay Keys, the senior. Keys looks like she's going to be tough to stop on the block. And one thing that's been impressive and one thing that's so key in these games is getting to the offensive glass, as we see Keys now a couple of free throws.
Yes, Keys definitely has a height and size advantage. over Walnut. It looks to be they want to go to her early and try to get her involved.
The foul was on Riley Quinn, and Quinn picks up her first. That's the first on either team. And here's the second free throw. That one a miss, and the rebound by Walnut. Cleared out of there by Becky Robinson, and now some three-quarter court pressure. Good hands and quick feet that time by the Tartars. That was Letitia McCullum, the senior.
Yeah, that time Taylorville set up in a 2-2-1 on that possession.
Walnut now again. We'll see this three-quarter court press as Pulse tries to break it. Walnut does now with numbers, running a bounce across the lane. Jumper in and out, and a rebound pulled in by the Tartars. Here comes McCullum in a hurry. No numbers, but a nice right-to-left crossover in the lane. The floater with the right hand.
Great move.
Very nice move. 7-4, Taylorsville. Almost halfway through this first quarter.
Taylorsville really getting after it on defense right now. The pressure is causing Walnut some problems early on.
And Tartars get their hands on that pass. It will stay with Walnut from the far sidelines, right in front of their bench. So here is Becky Robinson. Robinson, 12.1 per game, brings it ahead to Pulse. Pulse attacking along the baseline. Floater wouldn't go, and another good clean rebound that time by McCullum. Clears it quickly, pushing his bender. Coco, the crossover, had it kicked away, and it's out of bounds off of Walnut. Kind of surprised it wasn't a kick ball there.
All right. Should have been called. Just a great move by number 12. Great move by Bender.
So after a slow first 2 minutes, 11 points the last 2 minutes. As Walnut off a missed air ball, the rebound pulled in. Walnut the basketball. Here comes Presley Pulse. Pulse, leading scorer on this team for Walnut at 13 per game. Wanisha Adams, right corner. Lob inside, the catch and the lay-in. Nice job to get to the rim by Becky Robinson for her first two. 1 point gain. Here's Tartars in the front court. 2-3 zone by Walnut early. As Taylorsville also trying to be patient with McCurdy. Right side. Here's Cora Cooley, just a freshman. Now around the horn, Bender into the left corner. The catch by McCullum. For the one, and to go inside. They'll settle for a three, leave it short. And Pulse had her hand on the rebound. It's out of bounds. Last touch. Let's see what that whistle was. I'm going to say it's last touch by Presley Pulse. And so we'll stay with the Lady Tartars. Pass comes in. Drive and contact, no whistle, out of bounds, last touch by Walnut one more time. So Taylorsville getting a lot of opportunities on this trip as we see Sharnay Keys, the senior, check back in replacing the freshman Cooley.
Bender is doing a great job of trying to get to the basket early on.
From the baseline, it's McCullum. McCullum trying to go in along the wing, and they say didn't see the call that time.
5 second call.
5 seconds, so it'll be with Walnut. Here comes Becky Robinson. 2-2-1 again, as you were alluding to, Stephanie. I like the Tartars' defense right now. They are upping the tempo of this basketball game.
All right, Taylor was very long and athletic, so it's causing some problems for Walnut's guards to see over him.
Here's Pulse looking inside, and that pass telegraphed. A steal by Letitia McCullum. Nearly lost her dribble, but kept it alive. So McCullum will slow things down a little bit. 7-6 lead for Taylorsville, 2:28 to go first quarter. There's some good hands by Pulse. Pulse has got another one. Pulse is off and running with numbers. 2-on-1. Pulse down the lane to the rim, and a blocking foul going to be called on Tamara McCurdy, the junior. That's going to be the first on McCurdy. That's going to be the first on Taylorsville, and that will send Presley Pulse to the line. Pulse, a 62% free throw shooter. And to tell you how aggressive she is, 151 makes, make it 152 right there. She's gotten to the line now 246 times this season. Impressive.
That's really been aggressive. Just in that last possession, the one-on-one full court, you always want to attack the defender. And she did a great job of getting to the line.
She splits the pair. We're tied at 7. And the Lady Tartars waste no time into the front court. The catch by McCurdy. McCurdy along the wing. Right of the circle. Pass inside. The catch and a tie-up. Held ball. And it will be the possession arrow with Walnut. 2:08 to go first quarter. 7-7 our score. 2A semifinal. Winner will get new sight on Thursday afternoon, March 1st. Here's a steal and a bucket falling down by Tamisha Horn. And now Walnut finds themselves down two. pulse now. Right around the defender, right to the rack, and the lay-in good. Boy, that time, give Pulse a lot of credit. Charnay Keys got left frozen. 9-9 our score. Minute 40 to go first quarter. Again, looking inside for Keys and another Walnut steal. Pulse again in transition. Now a 2-on-2 to the rim again and spins one in with Moore English.
Pulse is a very impressive guard. You know, this is my first time seeing the play. She can really do some great things in the open court.
I was going to say, the second those thoughts, kind of taking over this ball game single-handedly right now. Here's the pass, McCollum. The extra pass inside, too much for Charnay Keys, the senior, to handle. And that might have been a case that time, Stephanie, of McCollum. She had an open 10-footer. You really got to take that shot as Keys was turning around to rebound.
Yeah, she said she's going ahead and just taking that one up. I don't think Keys was expecting the ball, but they're evidently trying to get to the Keys established inside early on, trying to get her back in the game.
We have a timeout on the floor. Minute 17 to go here in this first quarter. Walnut, an 11-9 lead. And when you look at these two teams, a little bit of history about these two teams. It was the first time in the Coliseum for Walnut since 1997. And that was when they played West Union for Taylorsville. First trip since 1980. And back in 1980, it was a win. Back then, it was AA, BB, and B, and it was a win in BB for Taylorsville, 52-44 over Bassfield. So both of these two teams ending these droughts, and both of these two teams, Stephanie, want to make sure that their stay here in the capital city doesn't end today.
Right. Just want to have a chance to advance. So if you get into the Coliseum at this point in the semifinals, anything can happen. So just want to play your best and hope you continue to advance.
So far, I don't think we've seen Taylorsville really settle into this basketball game. Presley Pulse has been really, you know, I think her name is so perfectly suited because she is kind of the heartbeat of her team. They follow her lead.
Right, you can see that early on. Pulse is under control. She's aggressive, and she's taking it right now to Taylorsville on her own. So I think everybody else is going to join her, but she's doing a great job right now.
As you can see, Walnut is not going to disguise what they are doing. As Walnut is going to Taylorsville going to put that full court pressure on, and Walnut's going to bring it down the floor. So Walnut in the front court, and Pulse with the basketball again out high.
Walnut is doing a much better job right now in handling Taylorsville's pressure.
Pulse goes right to the rim again, misses. Robinson there to clean it up. The stick back wouldn't go, and now there's a battle for it. Legs getting tangled. Pulse underneath, falling down, banked it in. Now, Stephanie, I don't know a lot about physical play, but that's really letting them play.
Yeah, that's getting after it. Both teams are doing a great job of being aggressive. Walnut doing a great job on the board. Got three offensive rebounds on that one possession.
Here's McCollum on the baseline. A push against Walnut. This is going to be against Becky Robinson. It'll be her first. And so from the baseline, Connors triggered in and have it taken away. The steal, the outlet. Here's Walnut down the floor to the rack, and the finish by Wynesha Adams.
It's a great finish by Adams.
Here come the Tartars, the three ball, left wing, good, by Letitia McCollum, the senior, puts it in. 15-12 our score, and a travel called on Pulse in the backcourt. Good defense by the Tartars, gives it right back to Taylorsville.
It's a big three. Walnut was starting to get on a little bit of a run. That three is going to try to get Taylorsville to settle down a little bit more.
Into the ball game now is Taylor Dole for Walnut. Here is McCollum off a screen by McCurdy. The jumper strong, no good, as the first quarter comes to a close. And as we see the score at the end of the first quarter, it is a 15-12 lead for Walnut through one. We'll pause for a brief moment. More play-by-play coming up after this. Fans, don't forget that you can buy a DVD of today's game. You can go online at www.mishsaa.tv to purchase DVDs of this broadcast. And I want to remind you that, boy, what a keepsake for you to have to cherish these memories for a lifetime here from the state tournament. Josh West alongside Stephanie Murphy. We've got our crew back in the truck taking care of us. 15-12 at the end of the first quarter. After the nerves were out of the equation, we saw both teams settle in nicely, both teams shooting the ball well. Taylorsville 5 of 10, 50%. Walnut 7 of 13, 54%. We're seeing solid basketball for both teams.
Right, great teams. Both doing a good job after settling in the first couple of minutes.
As Taylorsville the basketball, lob inside, the tough catch, turning left shoulder, missing is Keys, and the rebound on the backside. Here comes Walnut in a hurry with Doyle. Doyle bump, no whistle. And now Walnut going to set it up with Pulse. Well, they're going to run everything through Pulse, it appears. Here is Adams now right wing. Right elbow, pass right corner, the drive on the baseline, the bump. Again, contact, no whistle. And now Taylorsville trying to save it in on the baseline. And it will be Walnut basketball.
Keys did a great job on that possession of avoiding the charge. She just rotated over, just stood her ground.
So the lob going to come in up high. Deflection, a steal by McCollum. Off to the races now. From left to right. Here's a pass on the baseline. Driving the runner. And contacted now, a whistle. And we'll see going to the line. Coco Bender, the senior. Rod Walker, who writes for the Clarion Ledger, he loves her name. Coco Bender.
It is a great basketball name.
It's a great basketball name. Great name, period. And you can see that as being marketed at the next level.
Right.
Free throw is up and good. Bender, one of the top scorers on this team, one of the top three scorers on this roster, and makes a free throw early. Turning into this lead, back to two, make it a one-point game. Bender perfect at the line, two for two. And so Bender, her first 2 points, 15-14. Walnut by one, the basketball along the left wing. The drive, cut off
great
at the
pressure.
Short corner, and a good steal by Keys. And again, Tartar's running in transition from left to right, stopping, feeding inside. The catch right to the rack was Horn, and Horn will draw the foul. It's going to be the fourth foul already on Walnut, just one for the Tartars. And to the line will go Horn.
Taylorsville again coming out in the second quarter, opening up with some pressure in the half court. I think it kind of caught Walnut by surprise a little bit on the baseline.
As you know, defense leads to transition baskets when you can create turnovers like it did there especially, and the Tartars don't want to be stuck in a half-court battle.
Right.
Second free throw good. Tartars hitting their free throws. Taylorsville a one-point lead. A mini 4-0 run to start this quarter.
The 1-2-2 three-quarter trap by Taylorsville.
Here's Robinson.
In the middle.
Down the lane. Missing, and there's another good rebound by Horn. Horn going to push. Maybe with the exception of Keys, who's going to trail on that break, everybody can get out and run the floor and handle the basketball for Taylorsville.
Right, Taylorsville is very athletic and quick. Very athletic.
Bender right back to Horn. Horn had it poked away on the baseline. And so it will be Tartars basketball. We'll see checking into the ball game. Jamie Duxworth, the senior, for the first time in this one. We'll see Keys get a breather. The big senior center. Pass along the right wing. Here's Bender into the right corner. Catch in the three. McCollum left it short. And a rebound. And now a trap by the Tartars. A turnover. And a put up shot. No good. Rebound McCollum and stuck it in. Turnovers. Offensive rebounding. Everything the Tartars wanted to do right now, it's going their way. Thus the 6-0 run.
They're off to a great start in the second quarter. I'd say the pressure is causing a lot of problems. It's leading to easy baskets.
And quick hands again by the Tartar defense on the baseline. And can't say enough good things about the way Taylorsville is playing right now. And Pulse has got to kind of get her teammates right now and say, look, we got to settle down and run some things.
All right, now there she goes again.
Driving, stopping, popping, and putting it in. Well, that was on demand, wasn't
right
it, Stephanie?
Head.
18-17. 1 point lead for Taylorsville to answer and one. Nice shot that time by Coco Bender. And you talked about the athleticism. How about the strength that time by Bender to absorb the contact? The foul was on Presley Pulse, her first, so that's even a bigger foul. And that's the fifth on Walnut.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive to get an and one shooting a jump shot. But Ben is an impressive guard, though. She's doing a great job in this tournament early on.
20-17, Taylorsville by a bucket. Still a one-possession game. You have a feeling it might be that way all game long. Nice job of waiting by Adams to let the defender fly by for the lay-in. Here's Bender to Horn, trailing, jumper banked in. Taylorsville can't miss right now. But you look at Walnut, despite Taylorsville on this run, Walnut hanging around, only down three, and a travel by Robinson created off that full court pressure. If right now, if you're Coach Angela Moore, you've got to be thrilled about the way your team is up the tempo.
Right, they're doing a great job. So they evidently, pressing is one of their strengths, and this 1-2-2 is causing Walnut some problems right now. As long as they can continue to get easy baskets out of them and get to the line, then I'll stay in it as long as the other team is struggling with it.
Bender, tough shot and a little too strong. Robinson, the rebound, and Paul's forced to give it up against full court pressure. The pass to Adams, and Wynesha is fouled. Bender going to get whistled for her first personal foul. That's just the second team foul on Taylorsville.
That's pretty impressive, Bay, to press this way and not foul. That's shown a lot of discipline on Taylorsville's part.
Pulse ahead to Doyle. Pulse now along the near side to Adams. Pulse now, and Walnut intentionally wanting to catch their breath, slow this thing down a little bit. Makes me wonder, is this Walnut team as deep as there's a deflection? Nearly another steal. Now bodies to the floor. Pulse kept it alive, and this has got to be a foul on the Tartars, right?
I don't know. I didn't like the call.
You said you do?
I didn't like the call. It's the hustle play. Both of them going after the ball. I thought it was a 50-50 ball.
Probably if you're going to call it, you call it at half court, right? Before. As the foul was on McCurdy, the second. No question they've let them play. It's a pass into Robinson, and Robinson traveled. Took an extra step. 4:21 to go, first half. Taylorsville on top, 22-19. Cora Cooley, freshman, comes back in, and we'll see McCurdy go to the bench with a couple of personal fouls. Might not see her again until the third quarter. With the basketball, McCullum. Between the circles, they'll work it far side, a dribble drive to the rim, and again, Coco Bender getting to the basket, drawing the contact, and going to the line.
Bender's really putting the ball on the floor well and going aggressively to the basket. She's getting to the line quite a bit.
Two more free throws for a Taylorsville team that is 4-for-4 from the free throw line.
She probably rushed that one a little bit, probably shot a little bit too fast.
And, of course, I mentioned how good they were shooting, and that's usually instant
death.
Instant death. Second free throw is good, though. So 3 points for Coco Bender. Taylorsville a 23-19 advantage as Walnut going to meet some pressure at half court. Well, the Tartars trap.
In a 2-1-2 this time around, so they're changing up their defense or something a little bit from the full court to half court.
It's making Walnut think. Here's Adams, a deflection and a steal. Quick hands by Duxworth. Over to McCullum. McCullum pushing down the floor, down the lane, passes it off for a lay-in. What an assist that time. The dish from McCullum to Horn for the easy two and a timeout, Walnut. Good timeout. Very good. Well, Stephanie, 25-19. Taylorsville on top by six. If you'd have told me this is where it would be with 3:41 to go in the first half, I might have looked at you funny. That first 2 minutes, Walnut held the basketball, trying to just get a feel for this basketball game. Might not have been the worst thing for either teams, because I think both teams over that 2 minutes, their nerves settled in. Since then, this has just been great high school basketball.
Yeah, it's been good by both teams. So Taylorsville with the pressure is constantly keeping Walnut off balance. And they're actually doing good right now to only be down by six. Because you think about all the turnovers they have just in the second quarter alone and the easy basket that Taylorsville's getting, they're still in a good position because they're still in the game. So coach will make some timeouts, call some adjustments, maybe slow them down. They can maybe come in and break this run a little bit.
And again, as you touched on, a lot of strategy being right now. And I think more than anything, too, with the way that the Tartars have sped this Walnut team up, they've sped the Wildcats up. He's trying to tell them, look, we're okay, slow down. We need to do what we do. We don't need to let them dictate things.
Right, and they still got fine, so they're in a good position. They're only down six. So if they can get a bucket right here, they'll be able to kind of get a little bit more confidence. But they just need to settle down a little bit.
It's been balance for Taylorsville. It's been all Presley Pulse for Walnut so far. And that might be the difference of why it's a six-point Taylorsville lead. And here's a steal by McCollum. McCollum trying to feed it back and save it in. But a steal and a bucket by Wynesha Adams. Adams has 6 points. She came in averaging 6.2. She's almost at her average here in the first half. As McCollum, the drive, cut off into the corner. The bender three, long no good. And the rebound right to the Wildcats. As they'll clear to Robinson. Now Robinson averages over 12 per game. She's only got two so far. It'll be interesting to see if she can get going. Here's now back to the center circle. It's Quinn. Left wing, getting it over to Robinson. 25-21 is Walnut now going to slow things down a little bit. It's what we saw to start the ball game. On a bounce, here's Doyle. Doyle going to put it on the floor, and a bad pass, and a steal. McCollum, the long outlet, the catch, the flip ahead, and the lay-in on the other end.
Walnut's going to have to utilize some pass fakes and maybe throw a little bit more bounce passes. It's hard for them to throw over the quick hand of Taylorsville's guards.
Coco Bender, two more. That pass was intended for Bender. Horn ended up with it and got it right to who it was supposed to go to. The drive by Pulse. Pulse lost her dribble. Easy
quick hands again by
McCollum.
Taylorsville. They have very quick hands.
Here's a drive. This spin. Horn passes off inside for another Bender layup. Bender, the senior, one of the smaller players on the floor, but she lives around the rim for easy basket.
Right, she's doing a great job.
Biggest
playing with
lead
a lot of
game.
Energy and emotion right now, too.
Oh, you are exactly right. Pass into the corner. The three ball. Good. There's Becky Robinson. That's what we've been
they needed
to
that.
See.
They really needed that basket.
Here's Bender. Pushing, crossing over, down the lane. The left hand won't go. And a rebound pulled in by Walnut. So Pulse with just 90 seconds to go here in the first half. Taylorsville up by 5 points. Here's Pulse. Deep right side. Between the circles to Doyle.
Walnut. They really need to get a basket here.
Wanting to be patient. Pulse driving, attacking, and a push going to be called out on the floor. Just the 14th foul. Taylorsville still with two more fouls to give. Cora Cooley picks up her first. As we'll see a couple of fresh faces into the ball game for the Tartars. Amber McCollum as well as Kiwi Bradley, the senior, check in. Here's the drive on the baseline by Pulse and a charge. Taken by Taylorsville. Jamie Duxworth.
Duxworth did a pretty good job of rotating over that time.
There's some confusion as to if the official's going to come over and check in the ball. McCollum talking to her teammates, trying to slip it in on a bounce, and it's taken away by Pulse into Robinson, who misses the point blank shot. And here come the Tartars pushing with McCollum. Right to left and back left to right, and has to pull it back out. Walnut did a good job to get back defensively. Here's the lob at the free throw line. The 15-footer strong, no good by Amber McCollum. And here's the drive by Pulse, pushing, attacking to the rim, missing. And then Taylorsville got it but didn't square up. But then Taylorsville gets it right back. Now it's getting all of a sudden a little sloppy with just 30 seconds to go here before halftime.
Looks like Taylorsville's going to probably try to hold for the last shot.
Cora Cooley along the near sidelines, thrown away. Well, they were until that mishap. Kiwi Bradley had to go through her fingertips. ...29-24 Taylorsville. Chance for Walnut to wrestle back a little bit of the momentum. Right now it just feels like it's been all Taylorsville for about a quarter and a half. Here's good hands by Bender. 8 seconds to go. Here's a deflection by Duxworth. And they call a travel on Duxworth. Stephanie, you could see better than I could over the monitor. Did she ever have possession?
I don't think she ever had possession of the ball.
So Walnut's basketball, they get a good break. 6.4 seconds left. Three ball out of the right corner. Air ball, rebound by Taylorsville, and the heave with 3 seconds left nearly goes in.
That took a lot of strength to get that ball to the rim with one hand.
Good grief. That must be her spot, Stephanie, because she had 2.5 more seconds. She could have dribbled it into the front court. I was going to comment on that, and then it almost goes in.
Right.
Halftime we go, 29-24, Taylorsville by 5 here in the 2A semifinal. We'll pause for a moment, back after this.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera 3, beautiful. For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program and participate in the MHSAA network, go to mishsaa.tv/SBP.
A fast-moving first half here at the Mississippi Coliseum, as it is Taylorsville leading Walnut by a score of 29-24. First 2 minutes were definitely, a bit of a sleeper. But then when these two teams woke up, we saw these two teams shoot the ball very well, get up and down the floor, play an exciting brand of basketball. And I think we're going to be in for a lot in the second half. Taylorsville made that run, grabbed that lead, pushed it up to as many as 8, but Walnut will not go away.
Right, both teams are playing great in spurts. Like I said, Walnut started the game very strong, attacking and being aggressive. And then Taylorsville really turned it on in the second half, second quarter with their pressure. But both teams are playing great basketball right now. In the halftime, both will need to make some adjustments. But I think it's probably going to go down to the wire. It looks like it, at least.
A brief break coming up here at the half. And then when we return, right before the start of the third quarter, we'll take a look at those first half stats, reset your lineups, and get you ready for the start of the third quarter. Thanks for joining us. You're watching the MHSAA Network.
How am I doing?
Thank you. third quarter about to get underway here at the Mississippi Coliseum. MHSAA state championships to a bracket. Walnut High, Taylorsville High, and the winner of this game gets Newsight. Newsight defeated Bassfield earlier this morning, 55-45, to open up this tournament. Taking a look at those first half stats, you see the shooting numbers. You see 11 of 21 for Walnut, 52%. It was Taylorsville, 11 of 23, 48%. The assists very close, rebounds very close, turnovers probably a little higher than both coaches would want, but Taylorsville doing a much better job of getting to the free throw line. Six makes as opposed to two attempts for Walnut. So it's going to be interesting to see, Stephanie, how these two teams are able to make adjustments coming out of the locker room to start this third quarter.
Right, just a couple of things that Walnut may have mentioned, you know, just in the locker room at halftime, just handling the pressure a little bit better. When they do break the press, a lot of times they're missing the easy opportunities and layups that they are getting. So once they break it, they actually need to focus on finishing the layup and also maybe utilize a little bit more pass fakes to get around the athleticism of Taylorsville.
Taylorsville in the white, gold, and green. Walnut in the black, red, and white. And Taylorsville the basketball. And a five-point lead to start this quarter. Here's Bender driving baseline, feeding it off inside. It's kind of bounces around like a pinball. And coming up with it, McCurdy, left side, nearly a travel. Here's a pass inside. They're looking for Keys and a steal. Here comes Pulse. Pulse has got to take over for Walnut. She'll take it right to the rim and lay it in.
No doubt she's going to the basket in transition. So she does a great job one-on-one in open court.
Bender now to try to answer. She's fearless. That's been a good matchup, Pulse and Bender. Here's McCurdy, right wing, on a bounce. Bender, a good look at it. Three, bang.
Right now, it was almost like Walnut is there, and Taylorsville takes some outside shots. And that time, they got burned on it.
32-26, and steps called on Wynesha Adams right at the half-court line. Tauner's going to get it back, and Walnut's got to be careful. Taylorsville looks very relaxed. They've got a six-point lead, so they've got a little bit of wiggle room. Walnut's got to make sure this thing doesn't get away from them here in the opening minutes of the half. Here's McCurdy inside. Keys flashed open. Shot. That one not even close. And here comes Pulse. Pulse gets it ahead along the baseline and a turnover. It was right into the hands of Taylor Doyle. And Doyle just bobbled the basketball, turns it over. Now some full court pressure. Bender not phased, though, and now numbers. If she could hold the basketball, she does. McCurdy,
great pass.
A bounce inside. Very nice bounce. But Walnut somehow got a hand on it. That was Pulse again, and getting a steal, taking it right away from Tanisha Horn.
Pulse is very impressive. I like her toughness. She's really doing a good job of leading her team right now.
Great Here's pass. A nice little give and go for the lay-in, Wynesha Adams. And here's a steal on the baseline by Pulse. Back to Doyle. The jumper wouldn't fall. Keys battling for the rebound. Rips it away from two defenders. And then an unforced error.
See a lot more aggression coming out of Walnut. It's coming out from halftime.
Keys is coming out. Duxworth is coming in for the Tartars. And Stephanie, right when you think we're figured out these two teams, and all of a sudden a couple wacky trips happen, and you know, these two teams get a little sloppy. Again, these two teams had a combined 22 turnovers in the first half.
It seems that the pressure that Walnut has put on them has kind of thrown Taylorsville off a little bit, like they weren't expecting it at all.
Pulse, what a first step to the rack for two.
Great.
Here is McCollum. And McCollum had it poked away. It's going to be Walnut basketball. Last touch, McCollum might have gone off her knee.
Great timeout right now by Taylorsville. They really need to be settled down. It's kind of amazing. Most of the time, they say the teams that press all the time don't like to be pressured. And Walnut is throwing Taylorsville off with the press they're doing right now.
What's very neat is, again, you know, we see these teams, a lot of these teams we get to see for the first time at this level, at this tournament. But it seems like that Walnut just said, okay, we're going to give them a dose of their own medicine, as you touched on, and see how they like it.
And that's exactly what they've done, and Taylorsville is not handling it well. So as long as they're having trouble with it, as a coach, you continue to do it. But I like the aggression that Walnut came out of with at the halftime.
So Taylorsville needing to dig in defensively. That lead has been trimmed back to two. Taylorsville is led by as many as 8 points in this basketball game, but Presley Pulse is not letting the Wildcats fade away. She's keeping them right in this basketball game.
Right now, she's kind of taking the game over, at least in the early part of this third quarter.
Quinn from the baseline to inbound. Pass to Doyle. Doyle, the jumper, leaning, no good. Rebound tracked down left corner. Here's Bender. Bender now gets past three defenders in a hurry. Pass four defenders. Bounce pass inside for a lay-in by McCurdy.
Textbook got the ball in the middle of the floor and hit the person running the lanes.
And if Walnut can't control Bender, they might need to back up a little bit because, again, by the time she went baseline to half court, she had left four defenders in the dust.
She dribbled through it pretty easily.
34-30 Taylorsville. Pulse pushing. Doyle in the corner. Wanting to post up. Pulse on the block. Here's a drive. Adams loses her footing. Another painful collision. We have seen four or five collisions that, oh my goodness, I know it makes me hurt. I have some empathy pains from my playing days. What about you?
Right, both. I definitely got a knee ache over the past couple days.
Here's Quinn, a pulse off a steal to Doyle. Good look, and she knows how to finish. Taylor Doyle's got a bucket. 34-32, pushing McCullum on a bounce inside and a lay-in.
Taylorville out of that timeout is doing a great job of handling that press. They're getting easy layups out of it now.
Feast or famine. It's either been a bad turnover, an ugly turnover, or an easy transition basket on the other end. There's not been any in between. They haven't just gotten the ball in the front court and set up an offense.
Right. If they score again, Walnut may want to get out of it.
Adams again going full speed, this time being tripped by McCullum. And Tisha McCullum, the senior, picks up her first. I call her Letitia. That might be too proper. That might be just what's on her birth certificate. She goes by Tisha. I'll just have to start saying that as well. 36-32. 4:35 to go third quarter. Here's Pulse getting loose. Left to the key. Stops and pops. Leaves it short. And then a good job of boxing out. And the rebound, McCullum. Pulse going to pick up the foul, her second.
The foul.
So this is going to be, do you think, Stephanie, the make or break? Here's that pressure.
And this possession right here will tell a lot of us forwards if they need to stay in it.
Some 1-2-2. Here's Bender on the long outlet pass. Pass inside for a lay-in. No, in and out. Well, it's now kind of a neutral. They got the look they wanted. Taylorsville did in Horn, and it just
right, she
did
just missed that on her own, but they did break it fairly easily.
36-32. Taylorsville on top by four. Here's Pulse now, inside, wide open, the catch. Quinn had it blocked away by Horn, and Horn has it now, heading into the front court.
Horn may want to pick that one up. She looks a little nervous with it.
Here's McCurdy to McCullum, and Taylorsville now catches her breath. 3:40 to go, third quarter. The drive, the leaner, hard, crash to the floor. Good grief. We won't see any more physical play in some of the 5A and 6A games, and we're seeing right now the heart, the soul, the passion.
Well, they're playing hard right then. 25 actually probably could have got to the basket just a little bit out of control, McCullum was.
Riley Quinn the foul. That is her second. And at the line, the free throw is no good by Horn. She was 2-for-2 up to that point. Horn in this basketball game. Double figures already. I've got her with 10, and she misses both free throws, though. Quinn the rebound. Just a two-possession game as we're winding down this third quarter. 3.5 to go, third quarter. We play 4 8-minute quarters here in Mississippi High School basketball. Here's Adams in the right corner, and again, tripped up. As Duttsworth tripped her up. I want to know something. Is Adams that quick on her first step, or are the Tartars just a little clumsy and not really knowing how to guard her off the bounce? They're almost underestimating her.
I think it's a little bit of both. Taylorsville's kind of standing up on defense. It's kind of hard to close out standing straight up. And so they're not low enough right now to stay in front of her.
As my coach always said, keep that rear end down.
Hasn't been.
36-32. Taylorsville by four. Hard screen. Could have been a kind of a blocking foul there. She kind of extended those elbows. Got a good shot in. Here's Pulse. Driving off a pair of ball screens at the elbows. Now give and go. Gets it back. Puts it up. No good. A battle for it inside. Quinn's got it, and Walnut will set it back up. Boy, second and third chance opportunities. It'll be something to watch down the stretch as it always is. Adams on a bounce. Here's Robinson into the corner. Pulse cut off on the dribble drive. Now circles around to the rack and a lay-in.
Another great move by Pulse. She's really good at getting to the basket. Very good.
And showing her patience. Tartars have it ripped away. A steal by Doyle to the rim, and we're tied. We've got ourselves a brand new ball game. With 2.5 to go, third quarter, and Taylorsville going to call another very nice timeout.
Well, Walnut jumped in another 2-2-1 on that one.
I still don't know what to make of the press for Walnut. It's either going to be a steal in the lay-in or a fast break bucket for Taylorsville. But Walnut probably has shown just enough. They're going to stay in it,
right,
and it's going to make it interesting. It's going to make it fun get it, for us.
As long as you can get a couple turnovers out of it, you know, it gives you the confidence, okay, maybe they stay in a little longer. And Taylor is not killing them on a consecutive basis as far as scoring. So it's allowing them to stay in it a little bit longer probably than what they had planned to.
36-36. These two teams tied. You look at their records. I mean, Taylorsville on a 12-game winning streak, 24-3 on the season. You just take away that loss to Newsite. Walnut, a 25-8 basketball team. And having seen Newsite earlier in the day and then seeing this Walnut team here, it's hard for me to believe that Newsite ran the Wildcats off the floor 80-36. That blows my mind.
Newsite's very impressive. And traditionally, they're always very good. So nothing really surprises me as far as how they compete against opponents.
Taylorsville this time breaks the pressure. Pushing it left side, McCurdy to Bender for a three. No good. And a long rebound tracked out by Duxworth in the corner. Back to Bender between the circles. As Pulse is right there, gauging her every move. Now McCurdy, right wing. Man pressure for Walnut. Walnut is not back down at all. And Taylorsville and these two teams going to go down to the wire. Here's McCullum. McCullum going to work off a ball screen. Pick and roll. Down to the corner. A three. Bullseye.
A big
the
shot.
Three for Bender. It's her second triple of the ball game. All of a sudden, you look down and see 14 points for Coco Bender. She's been a difference maker.
Right. She's really been aggressive.
Here is Doyle. Give and go with Pulse, who got to the rim. Missed the layup. And that's just good pressure that time. She could feel Horn there on her shoulder.
Right, she may have gotten a little bit of a bump, but probably not enough to call it a foul.
McCullum to Duxworth, misses. Rebound to follow, fading away for Letitia McCullum. Just like that, a 5-0 run out of the timeout. And you got to give Coach Angela Moore a lot of credit. Her timeouts have been spot on.
Right. They do a much better job as far as making adjustments when they come out.
Adams spinning, finding her way in, turning left shoulder.
Big shot.
Banking it in. Wait a minute, is she a guard or a post? That was smooth.
Very. I think she's just probably going to do a little bit of everything.
Bender into the front court. Taylorsville by three. The bounce. McCullum working her way in, cut off. Now Bender thought about another three, now going to drive it wisely.
Great left hand.
Very nice, and misses. Could have easily gone down. Walnut a good rebound. Here's Doyle pushing. Doyle kind of tripped up, lost her balance, loses the basketball. Long outlet of deflection. Robinson going to get enough of it.
Oh, great hustle play
by Pulse.
Great hustle play.
Nowhere. Out of nowhere. And now even she's smiling about that. She didn't show that smile for long, just enough where her teammates could see it.
You have to love the effort by Pulse in that play, because she could have easily given up a layup, but she chose to make a play on the ball, so that's just outstanding effort in this type of atmosphere.
When you look at Pulse, and Pulse, the senior, as Bender shoots the three, it's going to be interesting to see where she plays at the next level, as we have a held ball on the floor, and that will be McCurdy tying up with Adams. The arrow is with Walnut.
Right, Pulse, she plays extremely hard.
18.5 seconds to go in this third quarter. Duxworth is out. We see Cora Cooley, the freshman, in. Who do you think's taking this last shot?
I think Pulse will probably take it.
I think that's a pretty safe bet.
Either Pulse or Adams, but I'll feel comfortable just having Pulse take the shot.
Pulse trying to get rid of it out of a double team. Cooley got a steal. Cooley now in traffic. 2 seconds, shot at the buzzer, no good, off the front iron again. Bender nearly able to finish another one as the basketball ends up under our scores table. 41-38, Taylorsville by three as we go to the fourth quarter. Back in a moment.
How many points a game is Keys averaging? She started the game, but she hasn't played very much.
We get it. Yeah. Fans, don't forget you can watch all MHSAA championship games live on demand at MISSHSAA.TV. And also, the championship games are going to be televised by Mississippi Public Broadcasting. That's going to be on MPB. And so that's going to be all 12 of those games, the six on the girls' side, the six on the boys' side. And as you see, 41-38, Taylorsville by three as we get set to start this fourth quarter. 15 points for Presley Pulse, 15 for Coco Bender, 12 for Tamisha Horn. Taylorsville out rebounding Walnut, 23-18, nine offensive rebounds by Taylorsville. Each team with 17 turnovers. And Taylorsville, the three-point lead in the basketball to start the fourth. Pass inside, turning left shoulder, banking it home is Keys. And Keys did a great job that time to get the angle to the backboard.
Right, I think Taylor's really going to have to count on Keys. They're going to hold on to win this game. I think she can give them more inside.
And I think that she, with her body, is going to be able to get to the free throw line. Here's Robinson along the baseline. Quinn, the baseline jumper. It brought rain. As that one, the high archer to get over the block attempt by the Tartars. And for Quinn, she's been fairly quiet. Just now 4 points, three rebounds, two assists. But she's provided solid minutes when she's been on the floor. Back to a one-possession game. Pass inside to Keys. Keys going to work on Adams. And Adams had pretty good position. Got pinned under the rim, but then had position for the rebound. Keys,
yeah, Keys has to make that shot. She has to make that shot.
She panicked, Stephanie. That was not a 6'4 post player. Good news for the Tartars is that Walnut turns it over, and there's a timeout on the floor. Again, the game gets in a flow. Then all of a sudden, we see an easy miss layup with a tall post player right at 6'2 on a 5'6 guard. And then Walnut in point-blank range, and they shuffle their feet. So, again, it's just been the Jekyll and Hyde for these two teams.
Yeah, and I think the closer it gets to the end, I think the nerves start to come back in when you know the game is kind of winding down and you're trying to make a play, especially on those easy possessions. It's almost like you're trying so hard to make it that you end up making it a completely worse situation than what it was to begin with. But Keys has to make that shot. They really need her to step up in this fourth quarter. If she catches the ball and takes her time, no one is really big enough or tall enough to be able to guard her, so she has to finish all those plays.
And you've got to give Adams credit. She got pinned in a bad spot on a switch. She's pinned under the rim. All she could do was not foul, because even if she does foul, she's not going to, with the strength of Keys, limit her from making that shot. That, as you touched on, all on Keys right there. But again, I think Keys will bounce back. But Presley Pulse and Walnut, and it's been Coco Bender and Taylorsville. And let's not go to sleep on what Tamisha Horn has brought to the equation. 12 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and a steal by Robinson to Pulse for the layup.
Walnut jump back in the 2-2-1 again.
A game-high 17 for Presley Pulse. Here's the runner. Missed, short. McCurdy the rebound. Held ball. And the arrow is with Walnut. So Walnut's going to get it back, down by one. Chance to take the lead again. And you go back to the end of the first quarter, it was 15-12 Walnut, as Walnut having a tough time getting it in. They finally do to Adams. Adams gets free of Bender, but Taylorsville outscored Walnut 17-9 in the second quarter. Believe it or not, Walnut has won two of the three quarters, but down one. Here is the pass inside of a lob. And a clean block, could have been a jump ball called earlier, but they came down and then the jump ball call.
Taylorsville may want to consider going down these last 6 minutes or just trying to deny Pulse the ball. They may want to consider that.
Taylorsville to inbound with Keys. Keys into McCullum, and McCullum going to go back to Bender, tap it right back to McCullum. Here's a deflection. Robinson nearly got a steal.
They may be in danger of a 10-second call here.
Here's McCullum down the lane on a bounce to Keys. The shot up, no good. The catch goes up and put in. Loose ball. Keys corralled it and put it in for two more. Going back to that 10-second call, which official was counting it off? I didn't see.
A female official.
Okay. I didn't see either because I was watching the ball. Here's the turnaround. It was very close. And there's another missed close opportunity. And Keys, you had a sixth sense there that Keys might take over. Two buckets, a big rebound, and now a timeout on the floor with 5:48 remaining. 45-42, Taylorsville.
That may end up being a big timeout for Taylorsville. I think she got poked in the eye.
Letitia McCollum, as you can see on your screen, shaking up a little bit. She's got her face in her jersey.
I think she may have got poked in the eye a little bit. If she had waited, she probably could have got the official to call an official's timeout. Like I said, the coach may need that timeout later if it goes down. It's a tight game. It looks like it's going to be a tight game all the way down the stretch.
Over the last quarter, it's been a one-possession game. It's seesawed back and forth. Taylorsville is led by as many as 8. Walnut led by as many as 3, and that was at the end of the first quarter. You know, Walnut, they're thinking, there's no way Newsite is 44 points better than us. We want another opportunity. For Taylorsville, they got a pretty good battle against Bassfield. They want to test themselves against who many feel might be the best this year in Newsite. Taylorsville's number one. Newsite is right there nipping on their heels. And so they'd love to see that North-South State champ matchup.
Well, it's going to be interesting.
Lob looking for McCurdy. Pass too tall. Robinson a steal. And now back to Adams and Walnut. Now can slow things down a little bit. It's back to a one-possession game. They're right in this game. They don't have to force anything. Here's Doyle driving through two defenders. Tough fadeaway jumper. Good grief. I didn't know she had that in her repertoire. She made that look easy. Here's McCollum trying to prevent a steal, but Walnut gets it anyway. Pulse inside, wide open. That's like stealing.
I'm actually surprised that Taylorville is having this much trouble with the press.
Taylorsville down one, inside.
And good job of attacking at that time, going to the basket.
The foul going to be called on Quinn. That's going to be her fourth. That's only the third team foul on Walnut. Taylorsville only has two. Here's a pass into the corner. Three ball on the way, no good. And there's getting the basketball. Inadvertent trip and a jump ball on the floor. McCollum that time, inadvertent trip, and I don't think I've seen that in a while, where somebody had the ball and just lunged down like a football player. Here's a trap in the backcourt. Pulse had it deflected away. Taylorsville gets a steal to the rim. A clean block by Doyle. Now Walnut in transition, going up and Adams a lay-in. How this game has changed.
Taylorsville getting showing a little bit of frustration right now.
Tigers have gotten a little sloppy. Bender down the lane to restore sanity. And as it blocked away, and Walnut right now challenging everything. Taylorsville can take nothing for granted. Now I think we realize why Keys, when she had an open look, kind of flinched, wondering where the defense was coming from. And another steal. Doyle down the floor to the rim. Foul from behind. Good sportsmanship as she's helped up to her feet. It looks like this one's going to go on Coco Bender. Bender picks up her second. To the line is Taylor Doyle.
You have to like the pulls of Walnut right now. They're really doing a good job, and they're pressuring, getting easy baskets out of it.
Doyle misses the free throw badly, and when I looked at her free throw numbers, just 41%, I had to scratch my head. 35 of 86, 35 of 87.
That's a lot of free throws to shoot.
And the Tartars turn it over.
Taylorsville just need to calm down right now. They're really panicking, really right now, for no reason. I think all the turnovers just led to frustration on their part. And once they get the press broke, they just need to settle down, take some time, and run a good offense instead of trying to go so fast.
Walnut came out of the locker room, said, we're going to try to come in here and beat you at your own game. We can press. We can make things happen. Tartars get a steal. But the Tartars, who play fast, as Bender gets to the rack, flips it up, and draws the foul. She's going to the line for two. But back to the point I was making, Tartars play fast, but you don't want to play in a hurry.
Right.
And Walnut has gotten this pace of the game up to the point where now Tatars are playing in a hurry and just not thinking through everything, needing to take a step back.
Yeah, they just need to settle down just a little bit.
Free throw by Bender. Strong, no good. And you can see the frustration on with Bender. Taylorsville wondering, okay, we were up eight. What just happened? Nothing's going in.
Yeah, right now they're thinking about the clock, too.
Absolutely. Thinking about this season as Bender makes the free throw. Bender's got 16 points. 48-46. It's Walnut by two. Here's Pulse. A bounce to Adams all alone. An easy lay-in.
Doing a great job of breaking the press.
And again, we see another turnover. McCollum ended up on her stomach again and couldn't pick that one up. Here is Robinson trying to get it to Pulse, and a good timeout by the bench of Walnut as we see Larry Tribble calling a timeout.
McCollum may want to be careful here. She's been showing a lot of emotion and frustration after falling down a little bit, expecting to get a foul call. This is not a good time to get a technical because she may want to calm down a little bit.
She just cut her eyes at the official there. Didn't say anything, just kind of cut her eyes as hoping she could kind of make eye contact where the official could see how displeased she was. She wasn't going to say anything. She wasn't going to get too animated at this point, but she is very visibly exasperated. As you look in to the Walnut bench, you can see the body language right now for Walnut. They are feeling it right now, and it's a very different look for a Walnut team that came out in the first 2 minutes again. Basically held the ball the first 2 minutes of this game, trying to feel their way in this one.
Right.
And now that they've gained their footing, so to speak, they've been off to the races.
Yeah, Walnut is relaxed and comfortable, and now Taylorsville looks panicked right now.
Panic might be an understatement. Here is Quinn. Quinn going to get it in to Pulse, and it's thrown away.
That may be what Taylorsville need if they can settle down and probably need to go inside the keys right now. That may be their best bet, to try to settle down and go into keys.
Josh West, Stephanie Murphy with you. And if we think we ever have this thing figured out, something like that happens, and Taylorsville has the basketball. The team we thought that was settled in shows nerves. Bender passes on a three. Back to McCollum. McCollum pull up 17-footer. No good. And a rebound pulled in. Here is Doyle trying to clear it to Quinn. It's poked out of bounds. Last touch
These
by McCollum.
These officials are really letting them play in this last 4 or 5 minutes.
Here's Quinn in the backcourt. Double team, take it away,
they
McCurdy.
They need this basket.
And right to the rim, it's Horn. They heard you, coach. Two more, 10 points. Two-point game, 50-48. The outlet at half court. Doyle going to slow it down.
Great decision by Doyle to slow the ball down and bring it back out.
Paul's trying to catch her breath. Here's Doyle. Picked up by Horn.
Walnut's going to run a little bit of a delay here to try to get some time off the clock.
And Taylorsville cannot go to sleep on Becky Robinson.
A little bit of a mismatch with Keys. Keys is just kind of standing in the lane, so one person will always be open to run some time off the clock.
50-48, the trap. Doyle remained composed. Now Pulse with the basketball. Pulse trap. As we see Bender trying to draw a charge. Here's Pulse down near half court, nearly a backcourt violation.
2 minutes is a long time to hold the ball. But I think Wallace is just waiting on somebody to break down.
Robinson going to drive on Keys to the rim for a lay-in.
Right, great possession. They got what they wanted out of there, but ran a lot of time off the clock, and then they got an easy layup.
52-48, 2:05 remaining. That was a big lay-in. The push, the lob, Keys, the catch, the turn, the miss, and the rebound for the Wildcats.
Keys has to make that shot. She has to make that shot.
That's two big ones, two big misses. The bounce, trying to get it back to Adams, poked away by Horn. The South number one, Taylorsville. They've had such a clean resume this year, 24-3. What's so good about this tournament is that you're not trying to impress the selection committee.
Right.
It's all on merit. You go out and earn it. 52-48. The pass. Center circle Pulse. clears it away before a trap could get to her. Doyle now double team. A deflection. A steal. Here come the Tartars. Horn to the rim.
Big steal and layup.
We got ourselves a two-point game. 52-50. Taylorsville nearly with another swipe. Bender's got to hustle to get back into play. Quinn in the front court. Quinn holding. Contact, no whistle.
Nobody's rotating up when the trap is coming.
Here's Pulse down the lane to the rim. Flips it up and a dagger.
And one.
And one. Well said. 54-50. 69 seconds left. We knew Pulse would factor into this game big. We could tell that in the first quarter.
Right, I like her steadiness. I like what she is right now. She's always playing in the calm position, so she's doing a good job right now. Always knows what to do. She always
patient,
knows what to do.
Very patient. Never flustered.
That may end up being the play of the game.
Free throw up and no good. Big miss. Rebound. Taylorsville's got it. Here comes McCollum. Now Taylorsville does have to move quickly. Down the lane, McCollum double pumps it up, no good. And the rebound by Robinson, double team. Taylorsville swarming defensive pressure. Walnut clears. Here come the Wildcats. Doyle to the rack, flips it up, and draws the foul. Now, this is the person that Taylorsville can live with fouling. She's only a 41% free throw shooter. She's 0-for-2 in the ball game. What's interesting about this is that Taylorsville still has one more foul to give. That was only their fifth team foul. What a big make there. 36 of 88 on the year. 1-for-3 in this one, but that was huge. Second free throw. Got them both. That was pretty clutch. 56-50. Taylorsville going to go to the bucket. Take the two.
Oh,
put it up.
That one go down.
Almost an and one.
49 seconds is still a lot of time. She can get two free throws here and probably jump into something.
Riley Quinn fouls out of the ball game. Not that a player would foul out is surprising, but the fact that we've had so few fouls in this basketball game, Quinn fouls out. For example, Taylorsville has only five fouls in the second half. Walnut has only five fouls. There haven't been many.
Right, the officials are really letting them play this game. So they figure it's a game to get to the championship, so might as well let them fight for it.
First free throw is up and no good by Tanisha Horn. For Horn, now 2-for-5 from the free throw line. 56-50. Walnut by 6, and she missed them both. Rebound by Robinson, clears it over to Doyle. And there's a big collision at the scorer's table near the Taylorsville bench.
Walnut just needs to make free throws from here on out. Knock down the free throws and play good defense on the other end. They'll be smooth sailing.
And then the Tartars are going to have to do something they haven't done a lot this game. Look for the three ball. They've been getting to the rim. They're going to have to look for some threes and expect Coco Bender to factor into that equation. Pass going to come to Adams in the backcourt. Adams on a bounce. Robinson across the lane. Easy lay-in. That might do it.
I think they just did it.
Khadijah Thomas, her first 2 points. 58-50, long three in desperation as if the game was ending. And a grab by McCurdy.
Don't get an intentional foul for that one.
An intentional foul. And boy, right now, McCurdy walking down the floor. You see her at half court, and she's fighting back tears. Hands on her hips, fighting back tears.
Right, it's tough when you get to this corner. You've worked so hard all season and see your season ending down in a matter of 25 seconds. It's a tough thing to swallow, so I can understand the frustrations on the kid, but they still need to show good sportsmanship.
And Walnut, first trip since 1997. Taylorsville, I hate to say this, Coach, but before I was born, 1980, that goes back a ways. Here's the second free throw. Good as well. A young lady who was 41%, slipped under 40% after she missed her first two of the ball game, has stepped up and made four clutch free throws. So we've learned a lot about what's on the inside of Taylor.
Right, this is players making plays.
She's just gutsy. Pass into the backcourt. Looking for Thomas, a deflection. Bender nearly got a steal. Thomas has it back and then grabbed. Nearly another intentional.
I think he may have called a double dribble.
Thought it was almost an intentional foul as they reached out and wrapped up and grabbed again.
Right.
18.2 left.
Trying to make a play on the ball instead of going after the player.
Here's the three ball, top of the circle, no good. A rebound. And
we may as well not foul now.
Walnut with Robinson into the front court. Thomas traveled with 3.3. Thomas was thinking, I'm going to score in this game. I don't know how many minutes I might get in the championship. I'm going to the rack.
Right. Thomas looks like a young player.
Yeah, Thomas.
No, actually, she's a junior.
She's a junior. Here's the shot, the heave as time expires. Walnut has gotten it done. 60-50, your final score. As the coaches shake hands, you see one of the traditions of this tournament. And in all levels of basketball, the players coming down to high fives. We will come back to put the close on this one. We'll pause for just a moment. Back to close after this. Is the score. Walnut moves on. They'll play New Site in the 2A championship on Thursday, March 1st at 1 p.m. So go ahead and make your reservations here in the capital city. Go ahead and get your hotels. Go ahead and maybe line up who you're going to ride with, perhaps, to save on gas. But it's going to be fun, and Walnut's going to be in that championship game. They're going to get their rematch. And you look at the stats of this ball game very quickly. Despite out being rebounded 30-29 and 12-4 on the offensive glass, Walnut finds a way to get it done. They place three players in double figures. Presley Pulse with 19, Taylor Doyle and Juanisha Adams with a dozen. And in the losing effort, Coco Bender, Tamisha Horn with 16. Coach, your final thoughts.
Well, final thoughts, I thought that the adjustments at halftime, with Walnut deciding to press, really made a difference in the game.
All right, well, as we look ahead to our next ball game, we'll be looking ahead to Baldwin and Bay Springs. We'll be back with that one in a moment.